Welcome to Fix Sleep Bedtime Stories Channel, your sanctuary for relaxation, meditation, and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this journey to relaxation. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our magical sleep stories. So, let the tale begin. The Genetic Code of the Illuminati. Chapter 1. The Hidden Code. In the dimly lit confines of his research lab, Dr. Ethan Harrow, a renowned genetic analyst, peered intently at the luminescent strands of DNA displayed on his computer screen. A sense of unease crept over him as he delved deeper into the genetic sequences. He was on the verge of an unprecedented discovery, one that could change the course of human history. Ethan's journey to this moment began months earlier with a seemingly routine project, analyzing genetic variations to better understand human evolution. His work at the prestigious New Dawn Genetics Research Institute had always pushed the boundaries of genetic science, but this project was different. It was here, in the labyrinth of the human genome, that Ethan stumbled upon an anomaly, a sequence of DNA that defied all known genetic patterns. As he probed further, the irregularity revealed itself to be a code, a complex and deliberate arrangement of genetic information. It was unlike anything Ethan had ever seen. The more he studied it, the more he realized that this was not a product of natural evolution. It bore the marks of intelligent design, a purposeful manipulation of human DNA. The implications were staggering. Who could have engineered such a sophisticated genetic code, and for what purpose? Ethan's search for answers led him to ancient texts and secret societies, where he first encountered the shadowy whispers of the Illuminati. Long thought to be the stuff of conspiracy theories, the Illuminati was a clandestine organization that had allegedly influenced the course of human events from behind the scenes. Could they have ventured into genetic manipulation as well? Ethan's research uncovered a trail of historical clues pointing to the Illuminati's involvement in scientific endeavors that span centuries. From the Renaissance to the modern era, there were hints of their hand in guiding scientific discovery and knowledge. But this was their most audacious project yet, the genetic code, a blueprint for shaping human evolution. The more Ethan unraveled the mystery of the genetic code, the more he realized the danger he was in. His groundbreaking discovery had not gone unnoticed. He began to sense he was being watched. Mysterious figures lurked in the shadows, and crucial data started to disappear from his lab. It became clear that there were those who would go to great lengths to keep the genetic code a secret. Ethan's once calm life became a web of paranoia and intrigue. He received cryptic warnings and veiled threats, urging him to cease his research. But his scientific curiosity and sense of moral duty propelled him forward. He needed to understand the full extent of the genetic code and its implications for humanity. The situation took a dramatic turn when Ethan was contacted by a mysterious informant claiming to have insider knowledge of the Illuminati. The informant, known only as Alexis, agreed to meet Ethan in a secluded location. Under the cover of night, they met at an old cafe, tucked away in the heart of the city. Alexis, a figure cloaked in secrecy, revealed chilling details about the Illuminati's plans. The genetic code was part of a larger initiative to engineer a new era of human evolution, to create a future where the human race was under the control of the Illuminati. They sought to mold humanity according to their vision, reshaping genetics to dictate human potential, intelligence, and behavior. Ethan listened in disbelief. The ethical implications were profound. The manipulation of the genetic code raised questions about free will, identity, and the essence of what it meant to be human. It was a power that could be used for immense good or catastrophic harm. The meeting with Alexis ended with a dire warning. Ethan was in grave danger. The Illuminati would stop at nothing to protect their secrets, and he was a loose end that needed to be tied up. Shaken, Ethan returned to his lab, his mind racing with the weight of his discovery and the peril it brought. The chapter concluded with Ethan sitting in his lab, the genetic code displayed on his screen. He was at a crossroads, torn between his duty as a scientist to pursue the truth and the danger it posed to himself and humanity. The shadows of history loomed large, and Ethan knew that his next steps would take him into uncharted territory, both scientifically and ethically. Chapter 2. The Web of Intrigue. Dr. Ethan Harrow sat in his dimly lit lab, the after-hour silence of the New Dawn Genetics Research Institute enveloping him. The digital display of DNA sequences before him painted a picture that was both fascinating and terrifying. He had unearthed a secret that was supposed to stay hidden, the genetic code, an Illuminati initiative to manipulate human evolution. But with this discovery came a cascade of danger and ethical dilemmas that Ethan was only beginning to comprehend. The realization that he was treading on dangerous ground became palpable when Ethan received a cryptic message on his secure research terminal. The message was clear: stop digging, or the consequences will be dire. Ethan knew this wasn't an idle threat. The Illuminati, with their tentacles spread across the globe, were more than capable of making good on such a warning. However, Ethan's scientific curiosity and his sense of moral responsibility compelled him to delve deeper. He began to scrutinize every aspect of the genetic code, trying to unravel its purpose. The code was not just a random string of DNA, it was a meticulously designed blueprint that could alter human attributes, intelligence, physical ability, emotional disposition, at a fundamental level. Ethan's investigation led him to historical records and secret archives that hinted at the Illuminati's long-standing interest in genetics and eugenics. From the shadows, they had influenced key scientific breakthroughs, subtly guiding humanity's understanding of genetics towards their own goals. However, as he continued to unravel, Ethan began to feel more and more like a guy perched on the precipice. The genetic code had profound ethical ramifications. It sparked debate on the nature of free will, the morality of genetic engineering, and the fundamental characteristics of what it is to be human. If so, why were the Illuminati acting as if they were God? Ethan's quest for answers took him beyond the confines of his lab. He ventured into the darker corners of the scientific community, where whispers of secret experiments and forbidden knowledge abounded. He met with other researchers who had touched the fringes of the Illuminati's influence, each sharing tales of unexplained disappearances and silenced discoveries. One such encounter led Ethan to a clandestine meeting with a former member of the Illuminati's scientific team, a geneticist who had defected from the organization. In a secure, undisclosed location, the geneticist shared horrifying details of the Illuminati's plans. They're not just manipulating DNA for the betterment of humanity. It's control thereafter, the geneticist revealed. The genetic code is a tool for shaping society according to their vision, creating a class of individuals tailored to their specifications, compliant, intelligent, subservient. The revelation was chilling. Ethan realized that the stakes were higher than he had imagined. The genetic code was more than a scientific anomaly. It was a weapon capable of reshaping humanity. However, Ethan's covert investigations did not go unnoticed. He became the target of surveillance, his every move watched. Unmarked cars lingered near his home, strange glitches appeared in his communications, and his lab was subtly tampered with. The message was clear: he was being watched, and his pursuit of the truth was not welcome. Despite the mounting danger, Ethan's resolve only strengthened. He knew he couldn't face the Illuminati alone, he needed allies. Reaching out to a trusted circle of colleagues and experts in various fields, Ethan formed a clandestine group dedicated to exposing the truth about the genetic code. The group worked tirelessly, piecing together evidence and formulating a plan to bring the Illuminati's machinations to light. But as they delved deeper, they discovered that the conspiracy was more extensive than they had feared. The Illuminati's influence extended into the highest echelons of power, governments, corporations, global institutions, all entangled in a web of manipulation and secrecy. As the chapter drew to a close, Ethan and his team prepared to reveal their findings to the world. They planned to release a dossier of evidence, exposing the genetic code and the Illuminati's plan to manipulate human evolution. But just as they were about to act, disaster struck. Their secure meeting place was raided, and the team was ambushed by unknown assailants. In the chaos, valuable data was lost, and team members were scattered. Ethan narrowly escaped, but the message was clear: the Illuminati would go to great lengths to protect their secrets. As he evaded his pursuers through the shadowy streets, Ethan realized that the battle he was fighting was not just scientific or ethical, it was a fight for the future of humanity itself. Chapter 3: The Ethical Abyss. In the wake of the ambush and the loss of critical data, Dr. Ethan Harrow found himself at a crossroads. The discovery of the genetic code, a tool in the hands of the Illuminati to reshape human evolution, weighed heavily on his conscience. The ethical implications were vast and unsettling. As a scientist, Ethan had always believed in the pursuit of knowledge, but now he faced a moral dilemma that challenged the core of his beliefs. Ethan retreated into isolation, taking refuge in a small, undisclosed location where he could ponder the ramifications of his findings. The genetic code was not just a scientific anomaly, it was a testament to the Illuminati's immense power and their vision for a new world order. With the ability to manipulate human DNA at will, they could engineer a future where free will was a relic of the past, and the essence of humanity was controlled by a select few. Haunted by the enormity of this revelation, Ethan delved into the historical context of genetic manipulation. He pored over ancient manuscripts, scientific journals, and ethical treatises, seeking to understand the roots of this quest to control human evolution. His research revealed a long history of eugenics, a dark path that had led to atrocities in the past. The Illuminati's genetic code was the culmination of this dangerous ideology, a modern-day Frankenstein's monster that threatened to unleash a new era of genetic tyranny. As Ethan wrestled with these thoughts, he realized that exposing the Illuminati's plan was not enough. He needed to confront the ethical abyss head-on, to spark a global conversation about the implications of such power. The question of who gets to control the human genome was not just a scientific one, it was a question of human rights, of the future direction of human evolution. Determined to take action, Ethan reached out to his network of trusted allies, including scientists, ethicists, and journalists. Together, they formed a coalition to raise awareness about the dangers of unregulated genetic manipulation. They organized symposiums, wrote op-eds, and conducted interviews, bringing the issue to the forefront of public discourse. However, their efforts were met with resistance. The Illuminati's influence was far-reaching, and they wielded their power to suppress information and discredit Ethan and his allies. Media outlets were pressured to ignore the story, academic journals refused to publish their research, and public figures who spoke out were swiftly silenced. Undeterred, Ethan and his coalition turned to alternative channels to disseminate their message. They used secure online platforms, grassroots campaigns, and covert meetings to educate the public about the genetic code. Their message was clear: the power to alter human DNA carried with it a great responsibility, and it should not be monopolized by a secretive and unaccountable elite. As their movement gained momentum, Ethan was approached by a whistleblower from within the Illuminati's ranks. This insider, disillusioned with the organization's objectives, provided Ethan with critical information about the genetic code's true capabilities. It was far more advanced than Ethan had realized, capable of not just altering physical and cognitive traits, but also manipulating emotional and behavioral patterns. Armed with this new information, Ethan's resolve strengthened. He knew that the fight against the Illuminati was not just a battle for truth, it was a battle for the soul of humanity. The prospect of a world where individuals could be genetically programmed to obey, conform, and serve was a dystopian nightmare that Ethan was determined to prevent. The chapter concluded with a clandestine gathering of Ethan's coalition, where they formulated a plan to sabotage the Illuminati's genetic laboratories. It was a risky move, one that would expose them to great danger, but they were willing to take that risk for the sake of humanity's future. As they dispersed into the night, each member knew that the coming days would test their courage and commitment. Ethan, alone in his thoughts, realized that the battle he was waging was about more than genetics. It was a fight for the fundamental values of freedom and individuality. The genetic code was a Pandora's box that, once opened, could not be closed. He was determined to ensure that it remained locked, its secrets never unleashed upon the world. Chapter 4. The Race Against Time. Dr. Ethan Harrow, now a central figure in a global movement against the Illuminati's manipulation of human genetics, found himself in a race against time. The whistleblower's revelations about the genetic code's capabilities had escalated the urgency of their mission. The coalition, a diverse group of scientists, ethicists, activists, and journalists, planned a daring operation to infiltrate and expose the Illuminati's secret laboratories. Ethan's role was crucial. He was to lead a team to infiltrate one of the Illuminati's most guarded facilities, where the core of the genetic code research was conducted. The plan was fraught with risk, but the potential to uncover irrefutable evidence of the Illuminati's plans and halt their operations outweighed the danger. The night of the operation was tense. Ethan and his team, equipped with state-of-the-art surveillance and hacking tools, infiltrated the facility under the cover of darkness. Inside, they found a world that seemed straight out of a science fiction novel. Labs equipped with advanced genetic sequencing machines, data centers processing vast amounts of genetic information, and secure vaults containing DNA samples from around the world. As Ethan's team gathered evidence, he delved deeper into the heart of the facility. In a secure data room, he discovered the full extent of the Illuminati's plans. The genetic code was part of a larger initiative called Project Genesis, a plan to initiate a new phase of human evolution under the Illuminati's guidance. The project aimed to create a genetically enhanced elite while suppressing traits deemed undesirable, effectively engineering a new social hierarchy based on genetic superiority. The ethical implications were horrifying. The Illuminati were playing God, using the genetic code to exert ultimate control over humanity's future. Ethan downloaded as much data as he could, evidence that would expose the Illuminati's plans to the world. But their mission was compromised. The facility's security was alerted to their presence, and Ethan's team found themselves trapped. A tense escape ensued, with close calls and narrow escapes as they evaded capture. Ethan realized that the Illuminati's reach was far greater than he had imagined. They had infiltrated the highest levels of global security and surveillance. The coalition regrouped in the aftermath of the operation. The data Ethan had secured was explosive, but releasing it was fraught with danger. They knew the Illuminati would retaliate with all their power. Yet, the truth had to be revealed for the sake of all humanity. A global broadcast was planned, a simultaneous release of the evidence across multiple platforms, untraceable and impossible to suppress. As the hour approached, tension among the coalition members was palpable. They were about to expose one of the most significant conspiracies in human history. The broadcast was a seismic event, sending shockwaves across the globe. The evidence of Project Genesis, the extent of the Illuminati's manipulation of human genetics, and their plan for societal control were laid bare for the world to see. The reaction was immediate and overwhelming. Governments, scientific communities, and the general public were in uproar. Protests erupted in cities around the world, calling for an end to genetic manipulation and the dismantling of the Illuminati's influence. Amidst this turmoil, Ethan and his coalition were both celebrated as heroes and targeted as threats. The Illuminati, exposed and vulnerable, unleashed their resources to discredit and eliminate those who had revealed their secrets. Ethan found himself at the center of this storm. He faced threats to his life, but he also received unprecedented support from individuals and groups who believed in the cause for which he had fought. He became a symbol of resistance, a voice for ethical science and the preservation of human freedom. As the chapter drew to a close, Ethan reflected on the journey he had embarked upon. He had exposed a threat that lurked in the shadows, changing the course of human history. But the fight was far from over. The Illuminati were weakened, but not defeated. The ethical debates about genetic manipulation were just beginning. Ethan knew that he would continue to be a part of this fight. The struggle for control over human evolution, for the right to determine one's own genetic destiny, was a battle that would shape the future of humanity. He was prepared to lead that fight, armed with the truth and a determination to protect the essence of what it means to be human. The story concluded with Ethan stepping out into a world forever changed by his actions. The future was uncertain, but one thing was clear: the race against time to safeguard humanity's genetic future had just begun, and Ethan Harrow would be at the forefront of this critical battle.